and welcome to the MVAC lab.
I'm research intern Cindy Kocik. We go out on field projects from spring through late fall. But once the temperature drops, the ground freezes, and the snow starts to pile up, we can no longer survey plug fields or dig. We still have plenty of work to do indoors, though. However long we're in the field for a project, it takes about 3 to 5 times longer to conduct the cataloging, analysis, report preparation, and curation for it back in the lab. So let's explore a few of those activities. Use the timestamps in the description box to jump to a specific one.
We make sure to properly care for everything we brought back from the field this season. For small projects, we can usually do this any time of year, soon after fieldwork. But for larger, multi-year projects, winter is a good time to focus on it. We'll wash, catalog, and analyze any artifacts collected. For basic cataloging, we categorize each artifact by material and type. Like a projectile point made of silicified sandstone. And we count the number of artifacts present in each category. We also note any plant or animal remains, which could later be analyzed and possibly identified to genus or species. Each specific location or provenience at the site investigated will have an acquisition number, and the artifacts and plant and animal remains will be cataloged by that number as well as their own individual end number appended to it to differentiate them from one another. Depending on the data we need to answer our research questions, we might perform fairly straightforward work, like measuring the dimensions of stone tools, calculating vessel diameter from pottery rims, and analyzing edge wear under a microscope. We sometimes send materials to other labs for more specialized analyses too, like radiocarbon dating. We can process matrix samples as well. We float the soil samples with water to separate the plant remains that float, the light fraction, from the heavy fraction full of denser materials that sink. Then, we can sort through the light fraction, looking for charred or dried out archaeological seeds and other plant parts. We'll also look through the heavy fraction to find artifacts, animal bones, and shell. Keeping up with reports is important too. We want to make sure our reports are submitted to and accepted by the review agency, usually the State Historic Preservation Office, so our clients can keep their projects on schedule and other researchers will have access to our work. We need to describe the type of work we did, like a survey or a larger excavation, and the results. We'll write about any artifacts and features found and explain any analyses or statistical calculations we performed. We'll also add field photos, maps, and pictures of artifacts to illustrate our work in the field and the lab. By taking points with GPS units in the field, we can easily use a GIS program, some of which are open source and available for free online, to plot the points on a high-resolution map and create an accurate digital map of our fieldwork. In the end, we pull all that information together to make recommendations for the project to proceed as planned or for further work, like modifying the project route to avoid a site or planning excavations if that's not possible. Here in Wisconsin, once the report is submitted and accepted, the Wisconsin Historical Society will add it to their database so authorized professionals, like archaeologists aiding project planners, can view it. We continue to work on longer, multi-year projects as well, to keep those on track for completion. Speaking of reports, photos, and maps, any project involves documents and records, like email correspondence, project plans, permits, and field notes that we want to curate. We'll collect these in a project folder and file it in our archives. We also keep digital records by compiling born digital files and scanning physical materials like handwritten field notes and sketch maps at the highest optimal resolution. This way, we maintain a robust physical and digital record of our work, and we can easily find it and look back at it when planning for new projects. Digitizing older records, like these field forms from the 1980s, to make sure those are preserved and easily accessible is an ongoing, important project as well. Like our records, we always keep artifacts stored as safely and securely as possible. But the colder months present an opportunity for heavier emphasis on tasks directly related to artifacts and other material collections. We want to stay up to date with any needed artifact care, keeping track of the acquisition numbers assigned in our artifact cataloging system over the past year, and compiling artifact databases. We might also take time to inventory and update our comparative collections, like the modern seeds and animal bones we use to help identify archaeological finds. We coordinate with different agencies and local municipalities to plan next year's fieldwork as well. As planners develop their projects, we might perform literature reviews to let them know whether any known sites are present and what kinds of archaeological investigations might be needed before they can begin their work. We'll contact the appropriate State Historic Preservation Office for information on sites and previous archaeological work in the project area. We'll also look at archival sources, like aerial photos, atlases, and plat maps, and county histories, to understand the history of the project area. For projects that are past the literature review stage, we might get into scheduling fieldwork, performing further background research, and requesting permits for archaeological work. Just as lab work and write-ups take longer than fieldwork, a lot of planning goes into a project before we walk a plowed field or excavate a shovel test. We also continue our outreach work beyond the lab during the winter, including presentations at local schools. These cultural tradition boxes are ready to share with third and fourth grade elementary classes. They have examples of artifacts people made or used at different times in the past, the types of plant and animal resources available at those times, and the general climate in each time period. We answer public inquiries about archaeology in the Wisconsin region as well. You can reach us a variety of ways, including by email, phone, postal mail, or a visit to the lab. The MVAC website lists all the contact information you'll need, and you can find a map there of our building on the UW La Crosse campus. One of the best ways for the public to contact us when they think they've found an artifact, like a worked piece of stone, is to send an email with a good photo, with a ruler, or something else that shows the size. If you're interested in visiting the lab and seeing the exhibits here on the main floor, we usually are open during normal business hours. It's a good idea to email or call first to arrange a time when staff will be in and available to answer your questions. It might be difficult to imagine warmer days in the field right now, but they'll be back soon enough. Until then, we'll be wrapping up projects from the past year, keeping up with cataloging, curation, and maintenance, and getting ready for whatever field projects come next. For more information, see the description box. And to further explore archaeological topics, find links to MVAC social media, and view and subscribe to our monthly e-news, check out the MVAC website. You can also donate online to support MVAC's work, including our videos. Thanks for watching.